An estimated 80,000 people packed the streets of downtown Atlanta this Labor Day weekend for the annual DragonCon Parade and Fan Convention. The annual parade is a huge draw, and viewing areas along the parade's Peachtree Street route filled up quickly. Atlanta police were highly visible throughout the weekend. The Labor Day holiday is one of the busiest in Atlanta, but units like APD's Mounted Patrol make some of the work a little easier.
This is our favorite event every year. So we come out here, and if you look at us, you can see where we're sitting. We're up high. I kind of compare it to a lifeguard at a pool. Sits in a chair elevated. We can scan the crowd, make sure everybody's safe.
Atlanta public safety departments are in high gear from now until February 2019, when Super Bowl 53 makes its way to Mercedes-Benz Stadium. The big holiday weekend gave police and fire a chance to get ready for the football crowds coming in winter. Diversity has been a hot topic recently in the world of entertainment. From books to films to television, the desire to see more representation is getting stronger. But there has been some resistance. City Talk's Troy Danicus spoke to fans at DragonCon about what they see as a positive shift to increase diversity in the world of fandom.
Labor Day weekend in Atlanta has become synonymous with DragonCon, the largest entertainment fan convention in the Southeast and second only to San Diego Comic-Con. Fans of every genre converge on the streets of downtown annually for this four-day event. Venture into the menagerie of costumes and you'll soon discover an open and diverse culture of geeks and nerds. But not all corners of fandom are so open to diversity. A small yet vocal segment of fans are unhappy about diverse representation in their favorite franchise properties. English actor John Boyega's casting as a stormtrooper in 2015's Star Wars The Force Awakens was criticized by some fans. And in 2006, DC Comics brought Batwoman back, but as a lesbian. The CW recently cast lesbian actress Ruby Rose to play the part in a live-action series. DragonCon organizers figured they would promote diversity instead of shouting it down. This is Atlanta, after all, home of the civil rights movement. They debuted a new diversity track this year, featuring over 20 different panels dedicated to the topic. We spoke with the diversity track's director.
Well, the new track was a way to expand on what DragonCon has always done, is being open to different groups. Not only is it a way to discuss differences, but also discuss our similarities.
Younger fans like Holden Fromion are happy to see minority actors in lead roles instead of being relegated to sidekick status. And as a cosplayer, increased diversity gives him options.
And honestly, if I ever saw like background characters that were minorities, I kind of root for them in the back of my mind. I'm like, go you, go. You know, I've always had sort of that issue, you know, there's stuff like Black Panther, that's a character I can kind of relate to. It's somebody I see on the screen. It's like, he resembles me. I can sort of relate to that. And also from a cosplay stance, it's a bit more accuracy that I can do. So a lot more opportunities for that as well.
Drew Borders, who came as Disney's only African-American princess, may have been discouraged as a child with a plethora of white Disney princesses, but she says loving parents helped her to come to an important realization.
I remember when I was younger, I really wanted to be Cinderella, but I think I was just so mad because I put on the costume and I just felt like I didn't look like her. I think that affected me a lot, but I'm glad to say I always had supportive parents, parents that made me realize that, you know, black is beautiful. And just because I didn't see myself in that role doesn't mean that I couldn't be like that.
Accepting people for who they are has always been the essence of DragonCon and the geek community in general. Increasing the diversity of superheroes and other favorite characters may help kids feel welcome and a part of something larger than themselves.
We are an all-embracing culture, and it's one place that you've always been welcome. It's a good place for kids, especially in teenagers, when they're trying to figure out who and what they are.
And by that measure, the new diversity track at DragonCon is already a success.
I want everybody to have a seat at the table to discuss science fiction, the thing that ties us together, and fiction. And feel welcome.
For City Talk, I'm Troy Danicus.